now and at the hour of our death.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
Be it unto me according to your word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
And the Word was made flesh.
And dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Pray for us, Holy Mother of God.
That we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
We beseech you, O Lord, to pour your grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of your Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his cross and passion, we may be brought to the glory of his resurrection. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, open our lips.
And our mouths shall proclaim your praise.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
Amen.
The Lord is full of compassion and mercy.
Come, let us adore him.
Come, let us sing to the Lord.
Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation.
Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving, and raise a loud shout to him with songs.
For the Lord is a great God, and a great King above all gods.
In his hand are the caverns of the earth,
and the heights of the hills are his also.
The sea is his, for he made it,
and his hands have molded the dry land.
Come, let us bow down and bend the knee,
and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God,
and we are the people of his pasture,
and the sheep of his hand.
Oh, that today you would hearken to his voice.
The Lord is full of compassion and mercy.
Come, let us adore him. Psalm 61 and 62. Hear my cry, O God, and listen to my prayer.
I call upon you from the ends of the earth with heaviness in my heart. Set me upon the rock that is higher than I.
For you have been my refuge, a strong tower against the enemy.
I will dwell in your house forever. I will take refuge under the cover of your wings.
For you, O God, have heard my vows. You have granted me the heritage of those who fear your name.
Add length of days to a king's life. Let his years extend over many generations.
Let him sit enthroned before God forever. Bid love and faithfulness watch over him.
So will I always sing the praise of your name. And day by day I will fulfill my vows.
For God alone my soul in silence waits. From him comes my salvation.
He alone is my rock and my salvation. My stronghold, so that I shall not be greatly shaken.
How long will you assail me to crush me, all of you together? As if you were a leaning fence, a toppling wall.
They seek only to bring me down from my place of honor. Lies are their chief delight.
They bless me with their lips, but in their hearts they curse.
For God alone my soul in silence waits. Truly my hope is in him.
He alone is my rock and my salvation, my stronghold, so that I shall not be shaken.
In God is my safety and my honor. God is my strong rock and my refuge.
Put your trust in him always, O people. Pour out your hearts before him, for God is our refuge.
Those of high degree are but a fleeting breath. Even those of low estate cannot be trusted.
On the scales they are lighter than a breath. All of them together.
Put no trust in extortion, in robbery, take no empty pride. Though wealth increase, set not your heart upon it.
God has spoken once, twice have I heard it. That power belongs to God.
Steadfast love is yours, O Lord. For you repay every
prophet Jeremiah, the second chapter, beginning at the first verse. The word of the Lord came to me, saying, Go and proclaim in the hearing of Jerusalem, thus says the Lord. I remember the devotion of your youth, your love as a bride, how you followed me in the wilderness, in a land not sown. Israel was holy to the Lord, the first fruits of his harvest. All who ate of it were held guilty. Disaster came upon them, says the Lord. Hear the word of the Lord, O house of Jacob, and all the families of the house of Israel. Thus says the Lord, What wrong did your ancestors find in me, that they went far from me, and went after worthless things, and became worthless themselves? They did not say, Where is the Lord who brought us up from the land of Egypt, who led us in the wilderness, in a land of deserts and pits, in a land of drought and deep darkness, in a land that no one passes through, where no one lives? I brought you into a plentiful land, to eat its fruits and its good things. But when you entered, you defiled my land, and made my heritage an abomination. The priests did not say, Where is the Lord? Those who handle the law did not know me. Rulers transgressed against me. The prophets prophesied by Baal, and went after things that do not profit. Therefore once more I accuse you, says the Lord, and I accuse your children's children. Cross to the coast of Cyprus and look. Send to Kedar and examine with care. See if there has ever been such a thing. Has a nation changed its gods, even though they are no gods? But my people have changed their glory for something that does not profit. Be appalled, O heavens, at this, be shocked, be utterly desolate, says the Lord. For my people have committed two evils. They have forsaken me, the fountain of living water, and dug out cisterns for themselves, cracked cisterns that can hold no water. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. We say together a song to the Lamb. Splendor and honor and kingly power
are yours by right, O Lord our God. For you created everything that is, and by your will they were created and have their being. And yours by right, O Lamb that was slain. For with your blood you have redeemed from God, from every family, language, people, and nation, a kingdom of priests to serve our God. And so to him who sits upon the throne, and to Christ the Lamb, be worship and praise, dominion and splendor, forever and forever.
Paul to Romans, the first chapter, beginning with the 16th verse. I am not ashamed of the gospel. It is the power of God for salvation to everyone who has faith, to the Jew first, and also to the Greek. For in it the righteousness of God is revealed through faith for faith. As it is written, the one who is righteous will live by faith. The wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and wickedness of those who by their wickedness suppress the truth. But what can be known about God is plain to them, because God has shown it to them. Ever since the creation of the world, his eternal power and divine nature, invisible though they are, have been understood and seen through the things he has made. So then they are without excuse, for though they knew God, they did not honor him as God or give thanks to him, but they became futile in their thinking, and their senseless minds were darkened. Claiming to be wise, they became fools, and they exchanged the glory of the immortal God for images resembling a mortal human being, or birds, or four-footed animals, or reptiles. Before God gave them up in the lusts of their hearts to impurity, to the degradation of their bodies among themselves, because they exchanged the truth about God for a lie, and worshipped and served the creature rather than the Creator, who is blessed forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. We say together a song of humility. Come, let us return to the Lord,
who has torn us and will heal us. God has stricken us and will bind up our wounds. After 2 days you will revive us, and on the third day will raise us up, that we may live in his presence. Let us born of the Virgin Mary.
He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come,
your
will be done,
on earth
as in heaven.
Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Amen.
Save your people, Lord, and bless your inheritance.
Govern and uphold them now and always.
Day by day we bless you.
We praise your name forever.
Lord, keep us from all sin today.
Have mercy on us, and Lord, have mercy.
Lord, show us your love and mercy.
For we put our trust in you.
In you, Lord, is our hope.
And we shall never hope in vain.
O God, whose glory is always to have mercy, be gracious to all who have gone astray from your ways, and bring them again with penitent hearts and steadfast faith, to embrace and hold fast the unchangeable truth of your word, Jesus Christ, your Son, who with you and the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Almighty and everlasting God, you hate nothing you have made, and forgive the sins of all who are penitent. Create and make in us new and contrite hearts, that we, worthily lamenting our sins and acknowledging our wretchedness, may obtain of you, the God of all mercy, perfect remission and forgiveness. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
O God, the King Eternal, whose light divides the day from the night and turns the shadow of death into the morning, drive far from us all wrong desires. Incline our hearts to keep your will, and guide our feet into the way of peace, that having done your will with cheerfulness during the day, we may, when night comes, rejoice to give you thanks, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty and everlasting God, by your Spirit the whole body of your faithful people is governed and sanctified. Receive our supplications and prayers which we offer before you for all members of your holy church, that in their vocation and ministry they may truly and devoutly serve you, through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies, that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit